Hello HEMA friends and welcome to this new video. Similarly to what I have done with the sottani, the upward cuts, today I am going to share with you three different positions useful to charge a fendente during a fight. Following the same logic of the sottani video, we will start in posta longa, which represents our first action which we have landed. It may be an attack or a feint, it doesn't matter now. From the extended position, we want to charge a blow in a way which provides cover in the meantime, be it in an active or in a passive manner. The first cover position we are going to use is the one I use the most, and you have probably already seen me using it in sparring. I am of course talking about posta frontale. This position is useful to parry both fendenti and high mezzani, and it is, in my experience, better suited for a shorter sword easier to handle. To make this action work properly, you need to work together with your torso and your arms. Notice that the parry, timing-wise, happens during the motion and not at its very end. In this parry, we need to exercise a lot of arms and body strength over the sword, instead of using its own characteristic at our advantage, while moving according to its own rotation principles. This means two different things. First, we are freer and we can use this parry in many different situations because it is lesser dependent by the sword characteristics. But at the same time, we need to be strong enough to move around our sword in this fashion at the needed speed. As always, pros and cons. That's why this parry better suits shorter, agile swords, which are, generally speaking, the one I prefer. The second position I am going to show you is inspired by Vadi. On one side it is named finestra, and on the other side is named frontale, and to be honest, I don't think it's a case. This position shares similarities with the previous frontale, which again is not a case, but is far better suited for a longer type of sword. That's because instead of moving backward the entirety of our sword, we leave the point a bit forward, moving back our handle. This is a smart way to avoid forcing the parry too much. This position also helps charging the blow thanks to the leverage applied between the hands, again ideal for a slightly longer sword. The last method I propose you is a parry in what it is basically called posta di donna altera. It is quite simple. While charging a blow with a large motion, we cover the side of our head and chest. This action is extremely useful in a number of situations. It uses the rotation of the sword at its finest and requires little effort due to its large charging motion. The downside is that it requires a perfect timing, as generally tends to be a very fluid and fast motion. This parry is useful while moving sideways, but it may also be used while being in front of the opponent, especially in its left version, by a right-handed guy perspective. Of course. As the Fiore manual seems to show, it is really important to have the arms positioned properly during the action, to leave you free to see with one or both the eyes the opponent during the action. Very good people, three simple ways to charge your fendente while reaching a covering position. Remember that if you want to support this channel, you may simply like and subscribe, and if you want to help me even more while receiving in exchange even more contents, check the link to my Patreon page in the video description. Thanks for watching people, and as always, see you next time.